It's me. I ain't doing nothing but talking shit. So y'all gotta, like, you know, encourage me the whole way along.
You're bomba clad listening live. It's Thursday night, man. You're smoking your spliff. You know, you forgot what day of the week it is, man. But you know, you tuned into the Skid Row. You know what I'm saying, brother?
Yeah.
My name is Nestor Rodriguez, a.k.a. motherfucking A, Nestorius. And I'm the host of the Nestorius Public Radio Show. Welcome. That's my man right here, Mr. Simon Kaufman.
Yo, this is Simon Says That He Says with Nestor Rodriguez.
Whatever he says, I do. You know what's up. What you gonna do? And that's my man to his right, fucking revisiting the Juice Factor. Juice Factor 9, Richie Rich, Richard Corbin.
That's right. Shrinking and dinking.
Yeah. You know?
I got my beef jerky. It's that fuck. What happened?
Oh, I fucked up? Oh, hold on. You know what it is? Hold on a second. We gotta do that again. That was me.
What happened, bro?
You know what happens with this template if I move it? Anyway, forget that. Don't worry about it. Start it. Yeah.
You want a Skid Row flow? Well, that's where I go after the show. I like to hang out with a couple of hoes. I get up on it. I drink motherfucking smoke chronic. I rock it. I get it hydroponic when you need it. I call my man Pete. He works and he'll bring it. Repeat it. Drop it back and then we drop and seed it. Blow it up again. Come in the mic and blow it up again. NPR, yo, we're the motherfucking superstar. Yo, that's what we do. Downtown Avenue, 6 of Olive. So you get a better get it and shot cop.
I can show you how to do it, what to do, and how to do it. Motherfuckers, make your nose and make him.
Yeah.
And you wish you blew it.
I show you what to do and what you do and when you do it. I rock fluid with the water that I drink, the Perrier, cause it make me fresh and don't stink when I pull up in the rink, drop the clink on a motherfucker.
Clink.
That brother. You never heard of. Yo, I don't mean murder. I mean, we just kicking it. Hanging with some ladies back at the pad later. Talking, maxing, flexing it. Relaxing and having sex
flexing
in it.
Yeah.
Getting affectionate.
Flexing it. You know. Skid Row Studios, motherfucker.
Thank you.
That's right.
That's eating beef jerky at the same time. That's what these youngsters can't do.
Yeah.
They got their little fucking computer programs and shit. No one can rock rhymes or eat beef jerky at the same time like we used to.
Yeah, rockin' rhymes and shit. Yeah, rockin' rhymes, you know it.
Man, they are after Obama, huh?
Yo, what the fuck? Seriously, what the fuck?
Dude, it's a new onslaught. They found a chink in the armor.
Wasn't this last year when the House shut down the government? Wasn't this the same douchebag that did it?
John Boehner.
John Boehner.
Yeah, he's on my congressional ass wipes.
Yeah. But I mean, wasn't it the same
nice
fuck
plug
that shut down the government last year?
Yeah, it's all the same guys.
For 5 weeks, while they go on fucking vacation, right? I don't understand where these Hamas motherfuckers are when you need them. You know what I mean? They should just take all these motherfuckers from the house and blow them the fuck up. I mean, don't you have any connections out there, yo? You know what I'm saying?
Well, look.
Yo, wait a minute. Are you drinking the motherfucking... The Perrier fucking Pamplemousse Rose, the fucking grapefruit joint?
Oh, I fucking wish, dude.
What are you drinking?
Dude, now you're making me wish I was.
What are you drinking?
I'm drinking L'Orange Lemon Orange. Oh, I wish I had the...
Lemon
what
Orange?
What did you call it? Pumple Dick or
let
some
me see,
shit?
Let me see. Lemon Orange?
What did you call that?
He's a Perrier master, this Nestor.
Oh, shit. You got the L'Orange. Lemon Orange. Now,
yeah, with the fucking apostrophe at the front of the word.
I'm talking about the Pamplemousse Rose.
Oh,
it's a pink
dude,
cap.
That sounds like a fucking strip club that only VIPs get into.
Put your dollar in the basket. No, it's the pink cap.
The pink pamplemousse rose.
It's the pamplemousse rose.
Yeah,
it's
call ahead. We'll get you a private room.
It's pink grapefruit Le Perrier, you know? Anyway, back to Obama. I was just fucking bugging out right there for a second, you know?
But
the thing that gets me is, hold on a second.
People hate him.
So this dude, John.
Old fat
name?
White people Boehner. Hate him.
John Boehner?
Yeah, John Boehner.
I thought you pronounced it John Boehner.
You do.
So last year.
He can do that also.
He's got a boner for Obama, that's for sure.
No, but last year he did the same thing, right? I don't understand how they get away with this shit, man.
Dude, it's just the Republicans being fucking 5 years old, man. They're just being so vindictive. That's all they do. They fucking, when they don't get their way, they stop any progress that's possible in this country.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
But don't we have other things?
And then we got the Tea Party.
Wait a minute.
And they're like even worse.
Right. Well, they want to have tea over this whole thing.
Yeah.
They want to drink tea.
They're like Republicans on steroids. I mean, it made the Republicans be like, oh my God, these guys
are
fucking
fucked. Well, they run the Republican. They do run the Republican Party. But, you know, it's just white guys, dude. There's white guys getting, you know, they're mad and they don't want, you know, the brother coming in and taking over the White House and shit.
What do you mean?
So they're good old boys.
The brother coming over and taking over the White House. The brother has been in the White House for
these are good old boys. He's been in that White House.
Well, why don't you fucking get over it already? I mean,
they won't ever get over it.
Why not?
Because they're old and fat and they don't change.
Well, here's the deal.
They covet that.
Who's going to pay for this?
Their politics to covet their racism.
First of all, we all know that no fucking judge in their right mind are going to in their right minds are going to take on this lawsuit, right?
Well, they're
saying that it might happen.
I read a couple of articles that said that there's no judge that would take this on. But for argument's sake, let's say you do find a nincompoop that does it. Who's paying for this?
They're lawyers.
No. Where's this money coming from? Do they have a pot, like a Republican jerk-off fund that they just, like, they can pay themselves? They can pay the judicial system, the court fees?
No, they definitely use the jerk-off fund in Congress and the Senate. One who gets voted in to become the electorate of the jerk-off fund.
What I'm saying is this money coming from their fucking private funds? Or is this coming from the general taxpayer fucking pocket?
Someone's getting jerked off. Someone's getting a briefcase. Someone's getting an envelope. Well, who cares where the money's coming from?
Well, it matters. It matters a lot because here's the deal. If Cheney, George Bush, all these cocklickers, John Boehner, Boehner, whatever the fuck you want to call them, if all those people want to take their own money, right? Their own money, right? And forfeit what they're getting paid for to do their job in Congress and do their own proceedings, then fuck them. Let them do whatever the fuck they want. But if they're going to use the United States tax dollar money to fucking go on a fucking witch hunt and do some bullshit, then I got a problem with that.
Let me tell you something. Do you know how much they spent on the Clinton trial? $93 million.
Oh, I know that. That was fucking Ken Starr.
Yeah, $93 million.
$93 million. Yeah. Right? Meanwhile, we have no money.
Meanwhile, me, you, and Rich would have done it for $30,000.
Yeah. Yeah. Me, you, and Rich, first of all, me alone, I would have taken Big Willie to the side and I would have said, dude, do over. You know what I'm saying? All you needed to do is say, that's none of your fucking business in front of the television camera. I'm married. That's between me and my wife. That's none of your fucking business. You ever hear of pleading the motherfucking fifth? That's all he had to do. You know what I'm saying? That's it.
Yeah, yeah. I think, I mean, their leg of stand on was that it happened in the White House and it was with an intern. And then that's when they start saying, it's your tax money. He's wasting your tax money by getting a blowjob on your tax money.
Right. You sound like one of those. You look like one of those. In fact, when I met you, I thought you were a Republican. I said, this motherfucker ain't gonna want to take a ride down to San Diego with me. We booked a commercial together. You know how we met. Anyway.
Oh, no, it's common knowledge in the White House. All blowjobs from interns should be done in the Cleveland or the Kennedy room or the Roosevelt room.
Well, the thing is, so the Republican-led House approved a resolution this Wednesday, that's yesterday, authorizing Speaker John Boehner, But I want to call him Boner.
Do it.
That's John Boner.
That's what being American is.
We should call him John Limp Dick, but he's Boner. To sue President Barack Obama over claims he abused his powers at the expense of Congress and the Constitution. The vote was 225.
Dude, Obama's going to wipe the floor with these guys.
Congress doesn't do shit. 225
to 201. That was the vote. 225 to 201. Republicans argue Obama's executive orders in a number of areas were unlawful because it's the job of Congress to make or change laws. But they believe his handling of the Affordable Care Act gives them the best chance at proving their case and are basing the suit on that issue. So basically, they're taking the Affordable Care Act, which none of them want. None of them want that, and they didn't. Right? That's what Ted Cruz was all about, right? None of these motherfuckers won, which I understand, but you're going to look, there's two sides to every story, right? So if you're a business owner and you have the Affordable Care Act, the burden of a lot of this money is going to be on the business owner, right? You're going to have to pay some of that
insurance. They haven't wanted anything that Obama's wanted.
Well, they want a big black dick, but they can't get that.
Definitely in the Cleveland room.
That's
is where you get your big in the White House. Everybody knows in the Cleveland room is where you get your big black dick.
The bigger dicker, the popcorn flipper. The
fucking rules.
Yeah, no he big black dick rules. In the Kennedy or Roosevelt room.
So no, go ahead.
No, that's the thing is that fuck it.
That's the thing, you know?
That's the thing?
Let's move on. It's not
that's important. The thing? Okay.
Look, dude, listen. We're in a period where there's so much information out there that is misinformation, and we're in a period where nobody knows the truth. The truth has become very clouded for people. I mean, you have such major extremes. Some people love Obama and think he's one of the greatest presidents, and some people will say things like he's Hitler. What? Or they'll say things like, you know, he's the worst president we've ever had.
They just use words like that so that they'll make some kind of fucking headlines. You know, that's it. They'll use a big word. It's all a big show. It's a fucking dog and pony show.
My point is,
because they're trying to utilize the media to get their point across, and then they scare everybody.
But not even the media. People you talk to in public or just out and about.
Yeah, because they're affected by the media.
Because there's no truth. Because nobody knows what the truth is. There's such a cloud over America in so many ways. Then no one, I mean, how could you have someone say, like, he's the worst ever? Oh, and he's great. I mean, it's so different. Like, the worst ever? There's so much confusion. People don't know what to think. They don't know what to decide on. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, with so many things that you could, like, look, so, like I said, Congress is going to go on vacation for 5 weeks. Which, by the way, do you get paid 5 weeks vacation?
No.
Do you know how much a congressman gets paid per year?
No.
All right. We're going to Google that shit. I guarantee you they...
Oh, it's about too much.
It's about like a quarter of $1 million. It's about a quarter...
I just don't understand the plus whole stance of Republicans.
That's just their base salary, dude.
So many
people get a lot of briefcases and envelopes.
Congressional salaries and allowances, okay? I'm going to tell you what the fuck it is. Here we go. What the fuck? Members.
All right, well, you look that up.
There's a whole document. Go ahead.
I really don't understand how there are so many Republicans in this country, and it's probably just because they don't know what the fuck they're talking about. Everybody runs around, and they hold, like, business owners up on a stick. But, you know, from what I've read, a lot of the laws and a lot of the things that are in existence right now and any of the changes, they don't really affect the smaller businessman, you know, the mom-pop places.
Who knows? It's so complicated.
What it does affect are the companies that make millions and millions of dollars. A small business owner, what he pulls in a couple hundred thousand dollars or something like that. This guy, you know, they put it in these people's heads that they're going to be the next fucking Walmart and then they're going to be fucked. But it's not the case. You know, a lot of these rules, you know, as far as like healthcare and all this stuff, it really doesn't apply to a business that can't afford it. It's not going to fuck their shit up. It's not going to really screw up their bottom line. You know, if anything, it's going to be a small percentage. Well, the big issue is, you know, you've got Walmart, you've got all these, you know, pharmaceutical companies and all of that. They're looking to get a lot of their shit, but taken away, you know, as far as taxes. Or they could be smart enough like Google and Apple and get offshore accounts, you know, and hide all their money that way.
Okay.
Or you could turn your phone off.
Okay, you ready for this?
I'm ready, son.
You ready for this?
Oh, yo, I'm ready.
Okay, so the Speaker of the House gets $223,500 annually. Mm-hmm. That's the Speaker, okay? Mm-hmm. For just, what are your qualifications? I'm a douchebag. I was born a douchebag. I can teach douchebagology.
Yes,
and,
I've been teabagged several times.
Yeah, right. Majority and minority leaders, $193,400 a year. Okay, all other representatives, including delegates and resident commissioner from Puerto Rico. A Puerto Rico! Ho! A Puerto Rico! Ho!
Why don't you apply for that shit?
Well, I'm...
You can be the delegate official from Puerto Rico.
Well, check it out. I didn't know that the application...
Well, now that we got it,
now I know.
You found the website with the application?
Oh, no, there's a website here. The fucking website.
What's the name of the title?
Well, hold on. It's all other representatives, including delegates and resident commissioner. So there's a resident commissioner.
You're the motherfucking resident commissioner from Puerto Rico.
Double dribbling, you don't stop. Rock the beat, don't rock it on the cock, cock.
Dude.
He's a resident commissioner because Puerto Rico's not a state. So that's how it works.
Well, I'm saying we got to get you to be the resident commissioner.
They get $174,000 a year. Now, the chief administrative officer is $172,500 a year. Clerk of the House, $172,500. Sergeant at arms, $172,500. Chaplain, $172,500. Legislative Council, $172,500. Law Revision Council, $172,500. All these other motherfuckers. A parliamentarian, $172,500. Inspector General, $172,500.
Okay, which one is anyone different?
Well, the other two guys, but I'm talking about, you're talking about like
a bunch of jerk-offs.
No, you're talking about like a million. Dude, do you know anybody in your circle that's making $172,500?
Yeah.
Just to talk shit?
Oh, well, hopefully us one day. We'll be on here talking shit, making money.
But I'm saying, they're just talking shit.
They ain't doing nothing but talking shit. No, I know. It's anyway, a mess. We have no leaders. And you know that $172,000, that's their base salary. Don't forget the briefcases, the envelopes, mm-hmm. the backdoor deals, the fucking skimming from campaigns, the kickbacks from
the maximum,
like major businesses.
The maximum annual salary for employees of committees as revised in the 2009 pay order is $172,500 for up to three staff members, two majority and one minority, $170,696 for up to nine staff members, six majority, six minority, and a maximum of $168,411 for other staff. The maximum annual salary for employees of committees in the Senate, as revised, is $171,000.
$50,000 spent on the spring hot dog picnic.
Yeah, no. Well, that's another thing.
Congressional hot dog picnic.
They each get about $200,000+ to spend. Plus, they get reimbursed for miles. And I doubt any of them.
Plus, they get free coffee at Coffee Bean.
Do they get free, like, airline miles?
Yeah, official office expenses allowance component of the MRA, which is an acronym for some shit that they do there.
Yeah,
$256,574. Anyway, the point is that these people, they get paid a hefty amount of money. Just right off the bat, from the tax dollars, they're gonna go on fucking vacation, right? And then they're gonna drop a fucking kumquat like they did last year when they shut the fucking government down. All these people do is wind up causing a lot of problems for us, the taxpayers. You know, last year they closed the fucking federal parks, right?
Mm-hmm.
They closed them all. So it's summertime. Your family wants to go on to fucking Yosemite National Park.
Nope.
Guess
can't
what?
Do it.
You better eat a bowl of dicker. You know what I'm saying?
You can't shake hands with Smokey the Bear because he's on vacation too.
Because he got
laid off.
Because he's got sticky shit on his paws. Anyway, so one of the things that Barack Obama was trying to pass, believe it or not. So here's the deal. We have a couple issues here that go on. So the federal government, right, on one level, is the Federal Highway Fund is running out of money, right? That's the highway fund that the federal government gives to each state, allocates to each state to subsidize,
roads.
You know, the roads, mm-hmm. right? Because the local governments, for instance, California, is fucking you. They're taking all the money that they're taxing in California. They're smoking it up somebody's ass.
And then they're taking the money from the government
right.
to pay for their roads.
Right, because how it works is the federal government gives you, they allocate a certain amount of money. Let's say $100,000 mm-hmm. for 2013, right? So 2014, the books are open, so you didn't spend $100,000, right? So next year, that's kind of how it works, right?
But you got to spend the $100,000 to get $100,000 the next year. Because right. if you only spend $50,000, right. then they're only going to give you $50,000.
Right.
Because they're going to go, well, you only needed $50,000, so right. we're only going to give...
Exactly.
So they got to spend that.
Exactly. Exactly. So on one level, you have to ask, what are our local governments doing with all the tax dollars? I'm talking about California and New York. What they're doing is... usually when you're driving down the road and you see a bunch of nincompoops breaking the fucking road for no apparent reason for the 50th time, what you're seeing is the local government, the state government has a surplus of cash that they didn't spend on fixing the road. So in order to justify them getting a federal subsidy next year, they, like we just said, you mm-hmm. have to spend that money. So
meanwhile... We got pipes bursting left and right over the past couple of years. Fucking, did you see that over on Sunset?
Got the pipes! The pipes! No, don't stop, rock the pipes!
They're supposed to replace those after like 50 years. Those dude, pipes are like 60, 70 dude, years old. They're dude, supposed
that
to
one
dig
was
them
90
up.
Years old.
Was it 90? See, they're supposed to replace those
what
after
is this,
a certain
on Sunset
amount of
near
time.
UCLA?
Yeah. Right near UCLA.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And what's
you
crazy
know, and that's,
is...
That's the,
but,
that,
you know what, but this is America for you. This is America, okay? This is what it is. You don't... You do something... You just put your head in the sand, and you end up having to pay more later.
Right.
They
right.
just renovated a $130 million renovation of Pauley Pavilion. They didn't
what
fucking...
What is that?
That's where the basketball courts. They just put $130 million to university.
Where's this? Pauley?
At UCLA. Where the,
okay, got it.
It was on campus.
Got it.
It's where they play
flooded,
basketball.
It flooded...
Got it. The, you're talking about you're talking about UCLA.
The gym just got flooded, and they just did a $130 million yeah. renovation. So now, instead of going in and fixing the problem, now you got two fucking problems.
Yep.
Now
yep.
the state's
but
gonna
you
have
know
to
what?
Pay for their Pauley Pavilion
but you know what?
Because it damaged.
You
all
know what?
Those
in New York City, the Metropolitan Transit Authority, the MTA, same fucking shit. MTA, you would think. Most people think it's a federal or government agency.
No.
It's not. It's a privatized entity that gets subsidy or subsidy from the federal government. So the same thing. So these motherfuckers. You know how old the New York City.
So does somebody own at the MTA?
It is a privately owned entity.
So there's some guy.
There's a chairman of the board. I mean, I would have to look. You can Google it right now.
That's interesting. I didn't know that.
Google it. I'm interested in finding out. Go ahead. Google it. I'm just curious. I'm curious.
Basically, if you're an angry fat woman and you want to yell at tourists who don't understand what you're saying, MTA is a good career for you.
Well, yeah. That's definitely. If you're fat. And you don't give a shit about anything in your life or your children's life.
You just
life,
want to sit in a box for the rest of your life.
You can just take an examination. Basically, it's very easy. If you're listening, I'll tell you, some of the questions go like this. Where does the statute... What borough is Coney Island located in? What borough is Yankee Stadium in? These are the questions. I took the damn test when I was in high school. And I guarantee you, they haven't changed it, right? So if you want to go to... from the, what do you call it, Battery Park to Yankee Stadium, what trains would you have to take? Just bullshit like that. These are basic questions that you would have to, you know, have, yeah. have the answer for that any moron could have. Anyway, so it's not a government agency, the MTA, and it's pretty much the same thing. What I'm trying to get at is that the MTA came, I think was built in the early 1900s, 1950s. Teens, something like that, and very, very, very little repair is done on, or maintenance, I should say, maintenance, right? But there's repairs when there's an emergency, right? So you would think that the tunnels, the trains, all that stuff has to be repaired little by little as it goes along, as opposed to waiting for some explosion to happen or some shit. Meanwhile, there's advertisements all over Times Square in the subway. There's advertisements all over any of the stations.
Who's making that money, MTA?
Well, yeah. That's another way that they subsidize the fare. Otherwise, the fare, which is now $2.50, would probably be $5. That's how they offset it. But anyway, so he was talking, you know, he's talking, Obama was talking about I mean, he's talking about the federal highway fund running out of money. But then he's also trying to pass or cock block this legal maneuver that these corporations like Google, Apple, Facebook, Twitter, what they do is they open up subsidiaries abroad.
Yeah, they buy a company in another country and then they go, oh, well, that's where we are.
Well, no, what they do is they make $5 profit in that company, but they filter all their profit that they've made in the U.S. there. Mm-hmm. They say we made $50 billion, but that was in our plant in Ireland. Right.
Yeah, but they don't build a plant there. They buy a company there and now they're stationed there.
Right. Right. So anyway, let me read some of that. This is one of the things that he's trying to do. Hold on. What's interesting about this, though, is that the United States of America is getting fucked out of billions of dollars in tax revenue. Mm-hmm. Right. By these corporations. I'm gonna run you some numbers. Right.
Yeah.
So. If the United States federal government had this tax revenue, they could in turn have more money for the federal highway fund, which as a result, I'm going to read you some of the side effects of the federal highway fund running out of cash in a minute. But this is what like Apple and Twitter, Google skirts the U.S. government's higher business taxes by funneling revenues through subsidiaries in Ireland and other tax havens. And this may not be new news, but the numbers remain staggering and disgusting. Google's Ireland-based subsidiary just reported a $22 billion profit on which it paid a grand total of 0.17% in taxes, or $37 million to Ireland. So basically, that's what it is. They don't say they're Irish or wherever it is. Ireland is not one of the only places where they have subsidiaries, because I read about this with Apple. Mm-hmm. Apple has subsidiaries all over Europe.
Yeah, it hit the news a couple months ago.
Right, right. Well, it's been an ongoing thing.
Yeah.
So not only are you losing tax revenue, right?
Mm-hmm.
Meaning you're not paying the United States government, but you're paying it to another country on top of that.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It's almost like a double fucking ass.
Well, you know, I'm not so mad that these guys are doing it. I'm mad I'm not doing it.
Well, that's another episode, though. That's another episode.
How do we get subsidiaries? That's what I want to know.
Y'all. What you need to do, man. What you need to do, man, is you need to crush up some motherfucking rocks. You know what I'm saying? And then, you know, you just bag them shits up, you know, and you just chill, nigga. You chill around the block.
Yeah, I've already been doing that. Now how do I get a subsidiary?
Y'all, we're going to get there, man. We're going to subsidiarize you, man.
Yeah, that's what it's all about, man.
No, but I'm saying, so this has been going on for a while. Let me just school the kids out there.
Yo, school the kids.
This has been going on for a while, and it's totally legal, right? Apple does it, and that's something that raised eyebrows in the Senate last year. I'm assuming that it was on the 201 that voted against.
Yeah, raised eyebrows that were blowing each other. Like, first their eyebrows raised, then their heads raised.
Because the Republicans come in and they go, oh, the government shouldn't have anything to do with how businesses do anything.
Right. But at the same time, you don't want to have a United States government. You don't want to have United States businesses have to, you know, be responsible for all this tax revenue that is owed on their profits. But then you're going to allow major corporations. Do you know how much a fucking Google stock
you allow them to write off things. Hold on. They get to write off everything. And then they get
Do you know how much Google stock is?
How much?
$571.60. That's a share, okay?
And it's split like how many times?
Samsung at?
It's I don't know what Samsung is, but they split a couple of times. But here's another one that you want to talk about American ingenuity. It's totally off topic, but Chipotle Mexican restaurants. Mm-hmm. You know how much that fucking share is? $672.50. So granted, Google was running at about 600 and change a share, right? And then they split or whatever the fuck, and they're down to 571.60 or whatever. And Chipotle came on the scene for about $40 when they first started. So could you imagine if you bought yourself 100 shares of Chipotle at $40 and how much is now? You want to talk about subsidiaries, Simon? That's what you need to be looking at.
My own Chipotle?
No, I mean companies like that. I mean, you have to be able to, you know, forecast what the trends are and whatnot. Anyway, that's Google also has a Bermuda-based subsidiary for the same reason, where they were funneling $10 billion in profits as of 2011. But then you have the Republicans arguing over the notion that the federal minimum wage shouldn't be raised any higher than $7.25 an hour. Mm-hmm. This is what I'm talking about. It's just like, you know, how much fucking money, right? How much fucking money do you need to? And here's the kicker, right? So the IRS, right, isn't going to go after Google, right, to do an audit. They're not going to go after Apple to do an audit because it would cost the federal government umpteenth fucking millions of dollars to do that. So guess who they audit whenever they're, you know, they got a hair across their ass? They audit Simon Kaufman. They audit me because they don't cost them anything. Right, they can just call you in. You'll have diarrhea in your fucking in your Fruit of the Looms. You'll go in there. You'll, if you're lucky. This is my advice to you guys. Right, this is my advice, kids. If you get an audit, go to Chipotle Mexican restaurant. Order the vegetarian burrito. Just a lot of beans and rice. A lot of beans. In fact, tell them less rice, a lot of beans. And do this for a couple of days before. You have your IRS audit. And while you're at the IRS audit, just take a shit in your pants. Just fucking do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's legal.
We've done it. We stand behind it.
It's tried and true. You know what I mean? Just the whole room. They'll have to fucking adjourn the fucking investigation. You go home, you wipe your ass, you come back the next day, and, you know, do it again. Fucking waste their money, waste their time as much as they're wasting your money and your time. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But this is straight up fucking ridiculous. So let me read you some of the trickle down byproducts of the Federal Highway Fund running out of money. This is interesting. So obviously, right, according to the AAA, the average American spends $324 a year on additional repairs and maintenance caused by poor road conditions, and that's just average. People in Los Angeles pay an estimated, guess what, $832 a year because of bad roads, according to the nonpartisan TRIP organization.
That's because we have nicer cars here.
Which is funded by a variety of transit industry groups. And in New York, it's $673, and I don't know why they mentioned Tulsa, it's $784.
Tulsa don't play.
But basically, you know, this federal highway fund running out of money basically means that there's going to be less road repairs that need to be done on a continual basis, maintenance, right? And then eventually the bridge fucking falls down and people just fly off of it. And then, oh, shit, we got to close the bridge.
Dude.
Yeah, fuck it. It's only low-paying white people. Fuck them. Yeah.
Look, it's just, you know, such a reactionary society. We only do anything in this culture when something really bad happens. So the bridge does have to fucking fall on people. You know, what was that bridge that collapsed a couple of years?
That was about a year ago. Yeah. Actually,
and then everybody went, and they started checking the fucking bridges then.
Right.
And everybody freaked out. It's just mm-hmm. reactionary. Nobody does anything. So, you know, nobody's going to change their tune about, you know, these corporations and all of that until the people run out of fucking money, and then they can't buy Apple products. They can't fucking spend. No, really. That's what's going to happen. Because
the people.
And Apple are not going to have, they're going to have all the money and they're going to win the game. And then what?
Well,
who's going to buy their shit when they don't have any money?
You're making an interesting point. One of the reasons. One of the reasons the game Monopoly ends is because one person gets all the money.
Exactly.
And that's what's happening in this country. The whole game of Monopoly,
that's how Monopoly
can keep playing.
Ends.
I'm saying I'm using the game of Monopoly as an analogy for the capitalistic system.
Please hit
the
me.
Capitalistic system or Monopoly can continue to go around the board if money is distributed. Until the game ends was one person has all the money, and that's what's happening in this country. That's what he's trying to say.
Got it. I hear you on that. I hear you. It's time for a big up right now. Big up, you motherfucker! We're talking too serious type shit here, man. We need to bring up the motherfuck factor, you know. Ganja breath, you know. Ragamuffin, you know. Turntable bullshit, maneskilumbari too. Whatever the fuck that was. Anyway. So, but what's interesting about the federal highway thing is that, so the prices of gasoline are supposed to be raised because Congress hasn't raised the 18.4-cent fee in 20 years. So when you look at the per gallon cost at the pump, let's say it's $3.99, wherever
18.4 cents of that goes to the federal fund.
Right, that's 18.4. That's it. But then you got local.
But then state gets some local more.
Local,
yeah.
State, mm-hmm. And then you have, yeah, then you have fucking rat fume surcharges and all that. At least $1.50, if not a little bit more, of your gallon of gas is going through all these agencies in as far as taxes and
yeah,
tax
so
revenue.
we can you know, help the senators jerk off over fucking August while they didn't do anything.
Yeah.
They left with shit on the table.
These motherfuckers, that's what I'm
saying.
They
left.
No.
They couldn't fix shit.
No. They left with a bomb of shit is what they did. Mm-hmm. They left a plop of shit, and they said, sorry, we're going to go to Disneyland. This is what I'm trying to say here.
Yeah.
They're going to Disneyland at the taxpayers' expense because we pay them 5 weeks vacation.
They just need to simplify everything. 5 weeks
vacation.
Why don't they just simplify
it? They probably get more breaks than that. That's probably just one break.
Why does
I'm talking about a vacation. That's a 5 week summer vacation. All right? Do the math. If you divide $172,500 by 52 weeks, which Rich
every American should be getting a 5 week vacation.
Rich is doing right now. Let me see. 1725 divided by 52 weeks, that's 3,000 times 5. Is that right? That's $16,586. That's how much they're getting for 5 weeks. Chill. That's nice. I want to apply for that. I want to be the fucking representative of Puerto Rico.
A Puerto Rico.
I want to be the representative of Puerto Rico. Anyway, so obviously, if there's less traffic, if there's less road improvement because of a lack of money in the federal highway fund, then there's not going to be that much traffic, obstructions and shit like that, like we've had the past couple of weeks here in L.A. on Moore Park and Riverside Drive, which it always sucks, and they're doing the same shit over and over again. Anyway, so that's one thing, and then anyway, that's it. So back to the thing.
Well, so they ran out of money in the federal highway fund.
But
yeah.
Hold on. They ran out of money in the federal highway fund, but yes.
Oh, I didn't know where you were going with that. I'm pulling up the article.
His bow
they ran
for
out
you.
Of the money in the highway fund.
How much? $400 billion on the F-35 fucking jet development. Could you imagine? This is unbelievable. Guys, out there, what you need to do is you need to Google the F-35 that was contracted to Lockheed Martin by the U.S. military. They basically won the bid, stating that they could develop about 2,800 of the jets for $233 billion, which has changed to 2,400 for about $400 billion. And I don't think that they've even mastered one.
Yeah, and the U.S. has spent nearly $400 billion on the jet, much more than anticipated. That money could be used to buy a $664,000 a year house for every one of the approximately 600,000 Americans who live on the streets. So instead of the failed F-35 fucking fuckface jet, which we didn't even need anyways, okay, we could have bought every single homeless person a house, which really brings up the concept when you really think about this. It's not about money. It's not about how much money we have. It's not about any of the issues. It's these issues we talk about as society. We have the resources to cure hunger. We have the resources to feed the homeless. We have the resources to get blowjobs for everybody on Tuesdays and shit, but we don't fucking use them.
Blowjobs on Tuesday and Tuesday shit. Yet? Unreal.
I don't open a restaurant called Thank God It's Tuesday.
No, it's Thursday. Yeah. It's Thursday.
Well, Thursday's not blowjob day. You got to come back
Tuesday. Let me ask you a question. Did you find out any information about whether the MTA is operated or owned by private? Is it a, who owns the MTA?
All right. Well, you know, I checked out my
you know,
my wonderful sources over at Yahoo Answers.
Right. Oh, Yahoo Answers?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
That way you get a couple of the different things. The taxpayers of the city of New York and its surrounding counties own, in quotes, the MTA, in the sense that their tax dollars go towards its operating costs. If you were looking for a specific name, that would be Jay Walder, the chairman of the MTA. That was, well, that was 3 years ago, so it's probably changed. But another guy says neither. It's a state-chartered public benefit corporation organized in 1965. So to the extent it belongs to anyone, it belongs to New York State.
So basically, it's a jerk. It's a circle jerk.
Mm-hmm.
They're basically saying that
hide the banana.
Individual, as a collective, the taxpayers of the United States of New York own it, but it's run or entrusted to New York State to run it.
Yeah.
So New York State mismanages it.
Yeah. So you got the chairman and then a board of old fat white people and maybe, you know, a black guy on there so that they don't seem racist and maybe a Puerto Rican. I don't know. But, you know, that make a lot of fucking money, you know, that run this fucking thing. And that's it.
Yeah.
That money goes.
Let me tell you something. If you want to swim, if you want to play the game in this country, you just got to get running. You got to go swimming with the sharks, you know. It's just the answer.
Yeah, I'd be interested.
This isn't a system. This isn't an economic system where you're just going to be like able to sit back and like have picnics on the weekends with your family and work some job. It's coming down to like, if you know, you got to get up and run with the sharks. Now, sharks don't run, so I don't know.
You gotta jump in the ocean.
So that's how much you have to run. Because imagine how hard it would be for a shark to run.
That's pretty.
So you
gotta
run like a shark with the sharks. You feel me? You can't just run like a fucking giraffe. Giraffes run.
Yeah.
Cheetahs run.
Yeah. This is what I want. I'd be interested in knowing. You know, all the senators and everybody. You know, you're talking about kickbacks and the secret briefcase. You know. Might have been happening, you know. I mean, I think it goes probably to some extent, but I think that where the real deals are and why you want to be in the Senate, you know, who wants to deal with that big fucking headache of, you know, everybody hating you or loving you and this and that? These people don't really love their country or care about the people as much as they say they do. You know, what it boils down, I'd be interested in seeing what their investment, like how good their investments are. Like, what is their return on the money that they put in? Because that's where the real kickbacks are coming. Because these businesses, you know, they've got kind of an inside track. And that's why they want these businesses to succeed so well. Because their money is directly dumped into.
Well, the corporations, you know, run the fucking government.
Well, right? They do. They run the government because they have all these people in their pocket because they slide some. You talk about insider information and you know, insider trading. Oh, you know, that's shitty for you and me, but it's probably pretty commonplace. But if you were to open the books and see how much these guys are making off of, you know, I started with $10 and now I'm a billionaire, you know. I mean, these guys have, I'm sure, a great portfolio compared to what they put in, you know, into it. You know, and that's really knowledge is power with that. You know, they get paid, what, $175,000? Big deal. There's a lot of people that get paid that, you know, for doing just a regular small job.
Yeah, they're making a lot more on the side.
Yeah.
Absolutely. They wouldn't be fighting for that position.
I mean.
If they weren't getting some set for life.
That's not new information. I mean, the thing is that the thing that's messed up here is that it's the absurdity of the whole thing. And it's the blatant absurdity of the whole thing. You know what I mean? It's the fact
we don't even need another fighter jet. We have enough. But, we have 8 aircraft carriers. No other country has one.
We had to pay those guys.
I mean, it's like that's just one.
It's the
tangible,
war machine. It's the industrial machine.
That's just one tangible thing there that you see that the government easily, lubricatedly, fucking drops $400 billion fucking dollars like nothing, like water, right? Yeah. That's just one thing. You have no idea how many other things go on here, man. And these guys, with a straight face, they not only do they propose a fucking lawsuit to the United States, the president of the United States of America, for not doing his job or violating the legalities of his job. You know,
he was doing his job too well. He was doing what fucking Congress couldn't fucking do.
Dude.
Make a decision, pull the trigger, and fucking do something.
Hold on a second. What happened? What happened when George Bush left in 2008? What happened? Where are all these motherfuckers wanting to file a lawsuit against somebody who called fucked up this country for about 8 years?
Yeah. Who called lied?
Cold lied, right?
Think about this. All the people that died in Afghanistan and Iraq was based off a lie. Mm-hmm. Think about that. All the people committing suicide, all the people with missing limbs, all the people wandering around that can't even get a job. And here's a question I have. If none of these veterans coming back from Iraq and Afghanistan if they're all having a tough time finding jobs and Michelle Obama needs to help, you know, is working with these campaigns to help them get jobs and we're all doing fundraisers and we're encouraging employees to hire them. If they can't find employment anywhere, then why does every Army commercial you watch show the "We'll get you real life job skills. We'll take you from the battlefield to the real world."
Here.
They walk off the battlefield.
No, you'd be fucking working at Chipotle.
Let me give you, I'm saying,
if you watch a commercial for like the military, they always talk about how it's going to get you ahead and help your family, and you're going to come out with all these job skills. None of these motherfuckers are employable.
It somehow because the rednecks are getting a little smarter. They got internet. They starting to read a little bit.
An idea of something, right? Let me give you just to give you an idea of in 2008. Let me give you an idea. So 2008, what stock prices were like for certain companies? Because one of the biggest arguments that people had back when, you know, 4 years ago when this president, when Barack was going to be nominated, was running for re-election, was that, you know, the country is in worse condition now than it was, you know, when George Bush left. Let me give you an example.
We're in a much better condition. Everyone feels like it's in a better condition.
Okay, so here's the deal. So, for instance, Bank of America, I'm just giving you a bank stock. Like, around 2008, right before, let me see, when the fuck was this?
Bank America.
No, I know that.
Bank of America. They're a fucking
piece of
shit.
It went from like $55 a share to like $8 a share.
They should have been dropped down to penny stocks and the doors fucking shut.
Dude,
that's shitty ass fucking company run by fucking morons.
But it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen because
everybody hates them. They're like AT&T. Everybody fucking hates AT&T, yet they still fucking use them because, I don't want to spend,
Verizon. Let me give you what Apple was in 2008. In 2008, Apple was, prior to 2008, Apple was operating at about 25, 30 bucks. So in 2008, they dropped down to like 15 bucks. All these shares, they just went down. Right? All these shares.
Oh, yeah. He fucked the place up.
And then right after 2008, like let's say 2009 around there, all these stocks started climbing. You know what those stocks are now? It's just...
Dude, he's fixed the economy and he's done it with like a weight.
Because they stopped the oversight committees on Wall Street. They just said, hey, you know, what's his name say? He's like, oh, the free market will balance itself. And that's like saying, let's let the greediest of the greedy fucking run Wall Street. Let's see how they'll do. You know, it's dude, what did they do? We had this just like an explosion of fucking people breaking the laws, completely just lying to people, you know, and taking everybody's money. Of course it was going to explode because there was no regulation. They lifted all the regulations off of that shit. And then what happened? You know, everybody went fucking bananas. And that's why it astounds me, because the Republicans want a free market society. So you want a market run by the greediest people that will eventually be the greediest of the greedy. Well, they'll do anything to take your fucking money.
Yeah.
And what did they do? They took your fucking money and went, ah, ha, 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 thanks, you. Madoff made the fuck off
money.
With everybody's fucking money. And he died? And but there's still all these people fucking broke. Because of this one fucking guy, because they allowed him by raising the restrictions, by lifting all these restrictions, and
under his watch, the federal government did not do its due diligence, which is to monitor what the banking system in America was doing. They allowed, for instance, the housing...
Because the Republicans don't want the government to fucking look
in. It's not Republicans, dude. It's bigger than Republicans.
No, I know that, but we have...
I'm just saying
we have federal regulations in place. So who's doing...
The federal regulations were lifted. All these...
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'm saying exactly what you're saying.
And Clinton did that.
Well, Clinton lifted Monica Lewinsky's skirt to see what she had, and then
Clinton lifted a spleef, man.
He put the skirt back down and just opted for a fucking slippery slosh. You know what I mean? So that's what happened there.
I think that was a little give and take on that one,
anyway,
too. I think he let that shit happen because he got, you know, he was trying to pass something else, I believe, is what happened with that.
Everyone's trying to pass something.
Come on. We're going to raise some money,
too. Gas.
We're going to raise some money to file a lawsuit against Congressman. Write to your senator. Write to all the fuck motherfuckers that know nothing about your life, man. Anyway, real quick. So a little bit on the light side. Did you read about that chick who stole some clothes from a shop? I think it was in New York.
I love this.
Was it in New York?
I love it when people... No. It was in Nigeria.
Nigeria News reported it. No, yeah, they reported it. I think it was in New York, but it doesn't matter. So it was in Illinois. The 27-year-old Illinois woman stole several items from a clothing store. She was busted after she posted pictures of herself in a shoplifted dress on Facebook. At the same time, the son of the owner of the store that she stole the items from posted on Facebook, you know, somebody stole these items, blah, blah. What are the chances, right?
Right.
So she posts this fucking picture of her ass, her stupid ass, like, ooh, look at me. And basically they catch her and she was like, fooped. Unbelievable. It's unreal.
Yeah, if you're going to commit crime, don't put it on your Facebook.
Well, I mean... You know, people are doing stupid shit.
That's about the dude that hit the bicyclist and then he posted it on fucking Twitter.
Yes,
or
that was a girl.
Yes.
No,
that's happened on more than one occasion.
That's just fucking retarded.
That's happened on more than one occasion. Not just with that guy. That was a kid, a white kid who fucking ran over somebody. And then he tweeted about it. Like, ha ha, I just ran over, you know, a couple of whatever the hell. Anyway, we're going to wrap up the show. We have about a minute left. And I wanted to give, my people out there a little bit of information, because I was just Googling this shit the other day about the specific absorption rate, which is, you know how we talk about the cell phones having too much frequency and radiation emanating from them?
Yeah.
Well, the federal government has a specific absorption rate, a SAR, S-A-R, rate, of 1.6 watts per kilogram of flesh. So that means if you're looking to buy a phone that has the least amount of that radiation that you're going to have to absorb, all phone models have that. Mm. Anyway, Google it. SAR, specific absorption rate. 1.6 watts per kilogram of flesh.
That's the maximum.
That's the maximum. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's the maximum.
But that, every phone, what you can do is
every phone the maximum.
You can Google,
so you can get cancer.
You can Google the make and model of your phone, yeah, and then put a specific absorption rate next to it, and it'll give you the specifics. Anyway, that's it for our show. You've tuned in. You fucking got schooled. You got kicked in the motherfucking grill with some knowledge. You know what I'm saying? With some gritty, itty, ditty motherfucking scientific tidbits. You know what I mean? So you tell your friends, go to iTunes, tell them motherfuckers to subscribe to Nestorius Public Radio, and that's it. You know what I mean? Just do that shit. Make it happen. Tell your people, and we'll be back soon.
Shit, so y'all gotta, like, you know, encourage me the whole way along. Ow. I ain't doing nothing but talking shit.